This is Joe. He's 33 years old, a doctor, and has three children. But Joe's life has been turned upside down by a conflict which has erupted in his country. The cause was territory disputed by two countries.
It was in my country, everything quite cold, and suddenly everything changed. So we were forced to leave, me and my family, and we arrived here in this camp.
Joe is on the move, fleeing the dangers of the growing conflict together with hundreds of his compatriots. Luckily, Joe is not a real refugee, and this is a trial of NATO's intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance capabilities. But it asks some demanding questions, like how does a military alliance like NATO fight against attacks on one front while making sure that people like Joe do not become victims in the conflict?
We have to remember that in most military campaigns, they're being conducted in somebody's home. So as important as it is to the NATO commander to understand the movements and intent of the enemy, he also has to understand the movement and intent of the civilian population who are non-combatants. So NATO's commitment is not just to the defeat of enemy combatants, it's also to the support and protection and repatriation and reestablishment of civilian populations during and post military operation campaign.
In today's conflicts, you need more than jets, ships, and soldiers. You need information. Broad, accurate, and up-to-date information. This can be the difference between life and death for those in and around the conflict, both military and civilians. Fusing all the available information to provide a clear picture to the right person at the right time is what this trial is all about.
One of the lessons that we learned from the Libya operation is that NATO did not yet have a network that it could build as part of the joint task force to integrate all of the joint sensors that were available. Here in UV-14, with the full joint task force structure, we have integrated the ISR functions of the land component, the air component, and the maritime component.
The Unified Vision Trial is gathering, analyzing, and sharing information from many different sources through multiple intelligence technologies, helping NATO forces to improve their ability to conduct future operations and to ensure that commanders can quickly differentiate between innocent civilians like Joe and potentially dangerous adversaries.
The structure that we are experimenting with here in UV-14 is the NATO Response Force structure, with the goal of integrating the tactics, techniques, and procedures that we refine in the trial in NATO NRF 2016, so that whatever conflict arises, whether it be humanitarian assistance, whether it be some type of security patrol engagement, all the way up through an Article 5 conflict, that we could incorporate these throughout the full spectrum of operations. We'll identify what security areas are most in need of coverage, and so we can assist local law enforcement, we can assist whatever security forces have been requested by for NATO to send into a conflict area. And of course, we can use the data to conduct targeting of a potential adversary and respond in any way that NATO needs to for whatever operation it's asked to participate in.
In the heart of the action, using technology to quickly understand complex changing situations remains a key challenge.
We live in an asymmetric world with many threats, some known, some unknown. Intelligence provides us the clarity of situation awareness, which then affords commanders the ability to have dominant maneuver through their area of responsibility, with confidence that they understand the threat assessment.
Within this scenario, there's an incredible array of capabilities being put to the test. Firstly, hardware, secondly, techniques, and thirdly, doctrine, tactics, and procedures. A multitude of ground sensors, surveillance balloons, jammer aircraft, surveillance aircraft, fighter jets, and sea and land ISR assets have been deployed. But all these technologies need a common architecture to work properly. And that is what Unified Vision 14 is about. And if it works, it will help the military and civilians, including people like Joe.